Another one. 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 Another one.
What you talking about?
You're worth more than gold. Melanin is ubiquitous in every entity on planet Earth that has hue color. Melanin is the source of what gives color to skin, hair, eyes, plants, oil, animals, volcanoes, everything imaginable that is creative and colorful. Melanin is 100% activated through sun contact with black indigenous peoples. Melanin has become a proud statement in the black community over the last few years, as we are now more than ever embracing our culture, color and hair, and it brings my heart great joy to see black women embracing their blackness, natural hair, distinctive features and beautiful brown bodies. Melanin is listed on the stock exchange and is worth $384.50 per gram. Melanin is currently worth much more than gold. The gram of gold is worth $53. The gram of melanin is worth $300, even more than silver, platinum, par, palladium, rhodium, and even coltan. Melanin is not only a pigment and a color, which in addition to being a biopolymer aromatic and an organic semiconductor, is worth more than gold, silver, platinum, palladium and rhodium, but how many pigmented people know that melanin, what biopolymer aromatic and organic semiconductor, responsible for the tone of human skin, the color of crows or black panthers, today has such a dollar value in the Western world. So for those who still hate the pigmentation or adore those of others, we hope that knowing this will lead you to a very high sense of self-esteem. Until the healing of the emotional and psychological effects of Marfa.
are people too. We like the birds and the bees, but we'd rather die on our feet and keep living on our knees.
The privilege of having melanin goes beyond the skin. By simply pronouncing the word melanin, you will automatically start thinking about the skin, for the simple reason that this is primarily due to the programming of those who do not want to that you know that it is also found in all the vital organs of the human body and even in the blood, because they know that the day they start talking about the essential functions of melanin in these other parts of the body, they will then be forced to give up the theories about melanin as blocker solar rays and consider it as a super filter. They also know that they will be forced to give the melanin the credit that they have struggled so hard to suppress it for all these decades, and explain why the conversations about their it rarely goes beyond the subject of the skin. Thanks to the study of melanin, they understood, like our ancestors, that sunlight was always the main source of our health, our strength, our obedience to nature, and the ultimate source of our knowledge, which has kept us civilized since the beginning of our existence. Unfortunately, in one way or another, thanks to indoctrination and propaganda, this knowledge has now been lost. This explains why indigenous peoples are now redefining themselves according to a doctrine offensive to the biology and in total violation of their own existence. That is why people who were once considered children of the sun are now deceived, thinking that this same light is something they should protect against. All our organs are dependent on melanin, which means that without it they would not function properly, because it is dependent on sunlight. WHICH is the best source of food for it. Once you understand that melanin is in your brain, in your central nervous system and other parts of your body, then you will better understand its true function in the skin. In other words, you will finally understand that the skin melanized works exactly in the opposite direction, i.e. instead of blocking a rejecting sunlight, it was designed so that it can enter the body, mainly through the skin and eyes, in order to supply these internal organs dependent on melanin. And sunlight. Lack of sunshine will compromise your entire circadian rhythm, because its direct light is needed for the secretion of the two most important hormones in the human body, namely, serotonin and melatonin, that pave the way for all other biological functions. These secretions are sometimes called the hormones of sunlight, because they are directly controlled by the day and night cycle of this star. Melatonin is extremely important not only for our physical health, but also for our mind and pineal gland, which our ancestors called the seat of the soul. WHICH also depends on direct sunlight. Conversely, the lack of sunlight over time calcifies the pineal gland and releases pyrophosphate in the blood, which when it binds to calcium, forms calcium salt, which eventually hardens the arteries, the heart and other vital components of the body. With this deposit of salt in the bloodstream, the whole body will become like a pillar of salt, because of the calcification of tissues, blood vessels, teeth, arteries and organs. So if you believe that the relationship between your body and our sun only stops at the skin, well, you are wrong, because it is much deeper than